to say Shalom Akiyom and Shalom Akwayam. And today, we're going to be bringing forth a lesson concerning Solid Foundation International Ministries, also Solid Foundation Israelite Academy. Okay? And today's topic is going to be, we're going to show you in the Bible that the Sabbath day is determined by the new moon. The Sabbath day is truly indeed determined by the new moon. Every Saturday is not the Sabbath. Okay, brothers and sisters? Every Saturday, once again, is not the Sabbath. As you'll hear some Israelite brothers, some camps telling you that every Saturday is the Sabbath day. That's not correct. The Sabbath, once again, is determined by what? The new moon. I'm going to get right into it. Before we get into the lesson, we want to say double honors to the elders and the apostles. Salutations to the Akim that's preaching this truth in sincerity. And last but not least, we want to say all praises and glorification and honor is due to Yahweh, Bahashem, Mamashah, Yahushah. Okay? Who the world know as God and Jesus Christ. Okay, so now we're going to begin with the lesson. It's going to be a short tape to show you, brothers and sisters, that the new moon is determined by the Sabbath is determined by the new moon. Okay. Now, this is the first verse that we're going to be going in concerning this lesson. Let's go to Genesis chapter 1. This is Genesis chapter 1. Okay. We're going to begin with Genesis 1 and 1. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. God, when you look at God, in the Hebrew, it is Elohim, which is plural. So that's telling you that there's more than one. So that's not the Most High. That is actually the celestial beings, the hosts of heaven, which is classified as angels. They created the heavens and the earth. And along with those angels was the Son of the Most High. Okay? So God, once again, when it said in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, it's not talking about the Most High, Yahweh. It's talking about the Elohim, which is the paleo, but if you want to say it in the Yiddish, it's Elohim. Okay? Which is the powers, which is the celestial beings. They created the heavens and the earth. But dealing with the topic, let's get down to verse, this is talking about the creation of the world. Let's go to Genesis chapter 1, verse 14. Okay, and God said, let there be lights in the firmament of heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be signs for seasons and for days and years. So what the Most High did through his creation, his angelic beings, he said, let there be lights in the firmament, okay, of heaven to divide the day from the night. Let them be for signs and for seasons. That's Genesis 1:14. Genesis 1:15. And let them be lights. And let them be for lights in the firmament of heaven to give light upon the earth. And it was so. And God made two great lights. This is Genesis 1:16. And God made two great lights. And the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. And he made the stars also. Genesis 1:17. And God set them in the firmament of heaven to give light upon the earth. Okay, Genesis 1:18. And to rule over the day and over the night, and to divide the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. Okay, verse 19 out of Genesis chapter 1. And evening and morning were the fourth day. Okay, so you can see that basically what we're going to point out, that we're going to point out verse 16 in Genesis chapter 1. God made two great lights. What are those two great lights? The sun and the moon. The sun is the greater light. The moon is the lesser light. Okay, the sun comes out during the day. The moon comes out during the twilight, the nighttime. Okay, and you also have the stars, but we're going to focus on this, the luminaries, which we're going to focus really on the moon, dealing with the new moon. This lesson is entitled, basically, the Sabbath is determined by the new moon. So, in Genesis chapter 1, okay, I just wanted to point that out. Genesis chapter 1 verse 14, we read that God said, let there be lights in the firmament of heaven to divide the day from the night. And let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. So the Most High in Genesis chapter 1 verse 14, he said, let those two great lights in the firmament of heaven divide the day from the night. And let them be for signs and for what? For seasons. So the sun and the moon, it's signs, and it's a sign to let you know the appointed feast days, to let you know these are holy days, the time of the event, to let you know what time these events concerning the holy days occur. So we're going to focus on the moon, not too much on the sun. We're going to focus on the moon to show you that the moon is very significant for signs and for seasons, okay? And we're going to show you that. So let's move on with the lesson, brothers and sisters, okay? Now, I'm going to get into the heart of the lesson. Dealing with the Sabbath is determined by the new moon. Okay. Let's look at Isaiah 66 and 23. Isaiah 66, 23rd verse. And it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, said the Most High. So this is talking about in Isaiah 66. It's basically talking about the kingdom to come. Because you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you're going to rule in the kingdom of heaven to come. You're going to rule over all these heathens. Okay? And basically, it says concerning Isaiah 66 chapter, because it's a futuristic prophecy. It hasn't happened yet. But concerning Isaiah 66 and 23, it says, and it shall come to pass in the kingdom that from one new moon to another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, said the Most High. So from one new moon to another, if you roughly paraphrase that, from one month to another, okay? From one new month to another, because the word moon actually is synonymous to month, because the word month, when you look at month, M-O-N-T-H, month actually is moon. It's a, month is a, an old English term for moon. Month is actually moon. You can do your research on it. You look up the etymology of the word month. You look at it in the Greek dictionary. You look at month. You look up moon in the Greek dictionary, which is 3561 in the Greek concordance, and it's neomenia. That's neomenia, and that's N-E-O-M-E-N-I-A. So, neomenia, this is how you say moon in the Greek, 3561, and it basically means new month. Okay, so a month is another word for moon, or moon is another word for month. You can do your etymology on that. Do the etymology of the word month, and you can see that it's no other than moon, okay? So, pursuing Isaiah 66:23, when the kingdom is established, he said that it shall come to pass that from one new month into another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship me. Now, why did it say from one new month to another, and then after that it said the Sabbath? Because you have two different Sabbaths, okay, in the Bible. You have the new moon Sabbath, which is determined by the new moon, which is also a new month. That's a high Sabbath too. You have a new moon Sabbath, and then you have weekly Sabbaths. There would be no weekly Sabbaths if there would be no weekly Sabbaths before the new moon Sabbath. The new moon Sabbath has to come in. All the Sabbaths after the new moon is known as weekly Sabbaths. Okay, so if the new moon falls on a Monday, well, for this whole entire month, the weekly Sabbath is going to be on a Monday. That's how that works. Okay, let's get you another verse, okay? All right? Because actually, if you look up moon in the Hebrew, I think it's 2320. And it is Kodesh. Moon in the Hebrew, 2320. Okay? And it actually just means month. And like I said, so forth. Let's give you another verse, brothers and sisters. We ain't want to prolong too much time dealing with these new moon lessons. Let's turn to take a look at Amos chapter 8 verse 5. Saying, when will the new moon be gone that we may sell corn? And the sap that we may set forth wheat, making the ephah small, and the shekel great, and falsifying the balances by deceit. So this is what the Israelites, the Jews, okay, this is the question that they asked Amos, okay, pursuing Amos 8 and 5. They said, when will the new moon be gone that we may sell corn? Why was the Israelites, why wasn't they selling corn on the new moon? If the new moon, if the Sabbath is not determined by the new moon, why were the Israelites asking this question out of Amos 8 and 5? It says, when will the new moon be gone that we may sell corn? Because you're going to discover that you cannot buy, cook, clean, nor sell on the new moon. You know why? Because the new moon is a Sabbath, a high Sabbath. Also, a new moon is a new month that comes in. So you cannot buy, cook, clean, or sell on the new moon. And this is the question that Israelites asked Amos, pursuing chapter 8, verse 5. When will the new moon be gone that we may sell corn? Yeah, because when that new moon is over, okay, let's give you a perfect example. Okay, when the new moon is over, let's say the new moon, fell on, let's deal with this in reality. The new moon is coming up, the new moon that's coming up for next month, which is July, is actually going to fall on a Monday. So technically Sunday night, because once the sun is down, once the sun is set, a new day come in. So next month, July 4th, which is a holiday, which you brothers and sisters are not supposed to be keeping, July 4th is actually going to be a new moon. And there's going to be a lot of brothers and sisters on July 4th participating and indulging in a lot of wickedness. And the Most High is going to kill a lot of you brothers and you sisters. You're going to kill your kids as well for profaning the new moon Sabbath, which is July 4th. So it's very important to know, basically, keep watch of the new moon, because the new moon can fall any time of the year, can fall on sometime, can fall on an event or whatever. Well, the new moon is happening, this upcoming new moon that's coming, it's going to fall on, it's going to be Sunday night, okay, Sunday night, and Sunday night technically would make another day, so Sunday night, Monday, will determine the new moon for July, and July the 4th is a new moon. So, since July the 4th is a new moon, next month, and the July 4th is on a Monday, so since the new moon falls on a Monday, then the weekly Sabbaths for July, after that, all the weekly Sabbaths will be on a Monday. That's how it goes, okay? All right, so going back to Amos 8 and 5, saying, when will the new moon be gone that we may sell corn, and the Sabbath that we may set forth wheat, making the afar small, and the shackle break and falsifying the balance of the sea? I just wanted to point that out. The new moon is a Sabbath, man. That's why they was asking Amos, when will the new moon be gone? Because that's a Sabbath as well. We're going to keep it moving. You have basically eight phases of the moon. We're going to go over those eight phases. You have eight phases of the moon. Okay? You have a new moon, which is a new month. And it looks sort of like an invisible moon. It looks like a very darkish moon. It looks like a dark black moon. Sometimes it's very hard to see. It's a new moon. It's known as a new moon. Some people call it the invisible moon. When you see that, that's telling you that it's a new month. Okay? And the Bible commands us for every new month, we're supposed to blow the shofar. We're supposed to show reverence to the Most High. Okay, after that, you have a waxing crescent. Okay? A waxing crescent. I'm going to put the pictures up before you, brothers and sisters, so you can see a perfect illustration of what I'm talking about. A waxing crescent, it looks like this. Okay? And then after the waxing crescent, you have the first quarter. Okay? And then you have the waxing gibbous. And then you have what they call a full moon. A perfectly round full moon. Very bright. It shines very bright. It's full moon. After the full moon, you're going to notice it's going to decrease. Okay? So, from a new moon, when you see the new moon, okay, just know from the time the new moon comes in, the moon is in its increasing stages. Okay? When the moon is basically, when it's waxing, the moon is increasing. And basically, the light would be on the right hand side of the moon. Whenever you see light on the right hand side of the moon, it's automatically letting you know that the moon is waxing, it's increasing. Okay, from a new moon to a full moon, once it gets to a full moon, it's going to start decreasing. Okay, so when the moon is waning, it's decreasing, and the light going to be on your left. So just pay attention, brothers and sisters. When the moon is decreasing, it's called waning, and the light will always be on the left. But when the moon is waxing, it's called when the moon is increasing, it's called waxing. And then the light will always be on the right. So when a new moon comes in, just know that it's going to increase all the way to a full moon. Once it gets to a full moon, like I said, the increasing stages is waxing. Once it gets to a full moon, it's going to start waning, which is going to start decreasing. And the light is going to be on the left-hand side. Okay? And so when you get your full moon, after a full moon, you have a waning gibbous. And then you have the last quarter. Okay? And then you have the waning crescent. And then you got that repetition over again, a new moon coming. So actually you got eight phases of the moon, brothers and sisters. There are eight phases of the moon. To be Hebrew Israelites, brothers and sisters, you must understand this. It's very important. Never let someone tell you that this is a revelation. It's very important. Eight phases of the moon. Okay? So, let's continue to move on. If you brothers and sisters have time of keeping up with the new moon, you're trying to keep track of the new moon, you're losing, you just can't keep this, it just seems like you can't keep up with the new moon. A good website to go to online is moonconnection.com. That's moonconnection.com. You can look at the moon calendar and it'll show you all the upcoming new moons for the months to come. That way you can stay on point with your new moon Sabbaths and your new months. Okay? So let's continue to move on. Every Saturday is not a Sabbath day. When I came into the truth, me and my wife and my kids, in my early stages of the truth, I thought that every Saturday was a Sabbath until I discovered that it's not. Okay? So, I want to bring this before you, brothers and sisters. I want to shed some light on this right quick. I want to say it's not sure. We're going to deal with, let's see, I think I said Leviticus. Yeah, Leviticus, I want to say the 23rd chapter. We're going to go there. Leviticus, the 23rd chapter. We'll go there. I just want to point out something to show you that the new moon is a Sabbath. So we're going to Leviticus, the 23rd chapter, which deals with feast days, holy days. And we're gonna look at the memorial of blowing trumpets. We're gonna look at the memorial of blowing trumpets. And this Leviticus, the 23rd chapter, the 24th verse, says, speaking to the children of Israel, saying, in the seventh month, in the first day of the month, ye shall have a Sabbath, a memorial of blowing trumpets, a holy convocation. So this is what Yahweh Bashem Yahshai Yahweh instructed the children of Israel to do through the mouth of Moses. And I have before me the new moon months for 2016, which I wrote down. I went on moonconnection.com and I wrote this stuff down. So we're going to focus on Leviticus 23 and the 24th verse. It speaks of the memorial of blowing trumpets. When is the memorial of blowing trumpets? The memorial of blowing trumpets is actually on the Sabbath month. The Sabbath month. When is the Sabbath month? We all know that the first month of the year, according to the Hebrew calendar, is March. Okay, sometimes it may fall on April, but it happens to fall on March for this year, for 2016. So March is the first month of the year, okay? Not January, brothers and sisters. Okay, what you must understand, concerning the new moon, you must understand that today's calendar is what they call a solar calendar. That's based on the sun. They base today's calendar on the changes of the sun, okay? We don't do that. The Hebrews, the Jews, we base our calendar on we base it on the moon. So the Hebrews, we base our calendar on the moon, okay? But the so-called white man, he based his calendar by the science called solar calendar. It's 360 days on the Hebrew calendar. It's 365 days on the solar calendar, I want to say. So today's solar calendar is based on the sun, while the Bible calendar, the ones the Jews kept after they left Egypt, is based on the moon. And that's the calendar that we go by. So let's go back to Leviticus, the 23rd chapter, 24th verse, concerning the memorial of blowing trumpets, which is coming up. So when is the Sabbath month? Well, since March is the first month of the year on the Hebrew calendar, okay, you're going to start counting from March on down till you reach Sabbath. So March, April, May, June, July, August, September. September is the Sabbath month according to the Hebrew calendar. That's the actual, September comes from the word Septimius, which means seven. Okay, and September actually was, that month was dedicated to Septimius Severus when he conquered the Roman Empire in 193 AD. Septimius Severus, they named the month September after him. So September, Septimius is actually seven. That's where September comes from. So September, the name speaks for itself. Okay, so September is not, once again, the ninth month. Okay, the seventh month. And on that month, we ought to have a memorial of blowing trumpets. But what particular day on that month? Pursuing Leviticus 23 and 24, it says, in the first day of the month. So the first day of September, September 1st, not according to the solar calendar, you gotta base September 1st of the new moon. Whenever the new moon comes in, okay, that'll create for September, that'll create the first day, that new moon. So I have the new moon calendar for 2016. And actually September 1st would be on a Thursday that's coming up. It's going to be on a Thursday. The new moon for September is going to be on a Thursday. But just remember that the days are calculated by the changes of the sun. So actually Wednesday night, September Wednesday night, okay? September Wednesday night, which would be September Wednesday night, which will actually be, let's see, Wednesday of September on the 31st. Okay, so Wednesday night actually would be Thursday night for September, if you understand what I'm saying. And Thursday night would create the 1st of September. And that's actually when the new moon falls. Okay, so that's a cold cut to let you see Leviticus 23 and 24. It speaks of the memorial of blowing trumpets used on the 7th month, on the first day. The first day of the 7th month, you're supposed to have a memorial blowing trumpets. And that means when September come in, you're supposed to watch for that new moon. So that new moon gonna create the first day for September. And that's when you have basically a memorial blowing trumpets. If that made any sense for you brothers and sisters. Once again, we gotta keep it moving for the sake of time. Alright? The apocryphal books, the 14 books that the Roman Catholic Protestants removed from the Bible in the 18th century. We're gonna go in those books to determine some more takes on the new moon. Okay? Let's look at Ecclesiasticus that everybody knows as Sirach. Let's look at the 43rd chapter, beginning with verse 6. That's Sirach, or some may say Ecclesiasticus. 43rd chapter, beginning with verse 6. Okay? He made the moon also to serve in her season for a declaration of times, a sign of the world. Sirach 43 and 7. From the moon is the sign of feasts, a light that decreases in her perfection. So Sirach 43 and 7 in the Apocrypha, it tells you that the moon is a sign for feasts. That's how you determine your feast days pursuant to Leviticus, the 23rd chapter. You determine your feast days by the new moon. Because the new moon, pursuant to Sirach 43 and 6, it says, he made the moon also to serve in her seasons for a declaration of time and a sign of the world. Sirach 43 and 7, for the moon is the sign of feast, a light that increases in her perfection. Sirach 43 and 8, the month is called after her name. Okay? So like I told you previously that month is just another word for moon. It's Sirach 43 and 8, the month is called after her name, increasing wonderfully in her changing, being an instrument of the armies above, shining in the firmament of heaven. So you can see that Sirach 43 and 8 speaks of this moon increasing wonderfully in her changing. Because we went over the 8 phases of the moon. The moon changes, it has 8 phases. Okay, now Sirach 43 and 9. The beauty of heaven, the glory of the stars, an ornament, giving light in the highest places of the Most High. That was Sirach. Some may say Ecclesiasticus in the Apocryphal books, the 43rd chapter, we read verses 6, stopping on verse 9. Okay? Let's get you some more takes concerning the new moon Sabbath. Let's see what else is in the Apocryphal books. Let's see. I think we pretty much covered that in the Apocryphal books. The sun and the new moon. And like I said, it just was a short lesson. I don't want to make it too long. But the Most High made his feast days according to the changes of the moon. We went over that, Leviticus 23. And we will look at one more. Let's look up Numbers. Chapter 10, verse 1. Okay. So just remember, before we go to Numbers 10 and 1, just remember the word moon is actually synonymous to month, and the word month is the same as moon. Okay. And the new moon, basically, you just got to understand that I think it's backwards in America today, because simply the calendar is supposed to follow the new moon. But people have it backwards today. They think that the moon is supposed to follow the calendar. But no, the calendar is determined by the moon. The calendar is determined by the moon. Okay? So the calendar doesn't follow the moon. The moon makes the calendar. Okay? That's why when you look at a timepiece, most timepieces are circular. Like clocks, watches, Why do you think they're circular? And it's in reference to this, there's in reference to the curvature of the moon. They in reference to the shape of the moon. Like your watches, your clocks. That's why most watches and clocks are circular, because they're in reference of the moon. The moon is a timepiece. And once again, the calendar is supposed to follow the moon. The moon is supposed to follow the calendar. Brothers and sisters. Numbers 10 and 1. This is a couple last verses. Numbers 10 and 1. Numbers 10 and 1. It says, and the Lord, Yahweh, spake unto Moses, saying, I'm going to stop on verse 3. Make thee two trumpets of silver, of a whole piece, shall thou make them, that thou may use them for the calling of the assembly, and for the journeying of camps. Okay? Numbers 10, verse 3. And when they shall blow with them, all the assembly shall assemble themselves to thee at the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. Alright? Now let's look down at verse 10, out of Numbers 10. Also in the day of your gladness, and in your solemn days, and in the beginning of your months, ye shall blow with the trumpets over your burnt offerings, and over the sacrifices of your peace offerings, that they may be to you for a memorial before your God. I am the Lord your God, Yahweh. So, let's focus on Numbers 10 and 10. It says, also in the day of your gladness and your solemn days, and in the beginning of your months. When is the beginning of the month? It's determined by the new moon. It says, in the beginning of your months, it says, you shall do what? Ye shall blow with the trumpets over your burnt offerings. Now, we don't do burnt offerings, neither do we do peace offerings, because that was under the Levitical priest order, which is gone away. Yahweh is now high priest, so we don't no longer do the burnt offerings, or we don't no longer do the peace offerings. We just sacrifice, we substitute the burnt offerings with cookings or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Before that new moon come in. But this is what you're supposed to do on the new moon. You're supposed to blow the trumpet. Okay? And I just wanted to bring that out of Numbers 10 and 10, because it said the beginning of the months. When is that? The new moon. The new moon determines the beginning of the months. The new moon also is a new month also, which is a high Sabbath. And you can see right there, brothers and sisters. So I think that's pretty much of the lesson. We can go to Psalms 81 and 3 to show you, brothers and sisters, when the new moon come in, you're supposed to blow the shofar. You're supposed to blow the shofar. You're supposed to sound the alarm. You're supposed to give great praise and adulation towards the Most High. You're supposed to celebrate every new moon, which is a new month that comes in. Don't celebrate the moon, because we ain't about moon worship. The Bible tells us not to celebrate and worship the firmaments of heaven, but we're not celebrating the moon. We're celebrating the new month. We're thanking the Most High for allowing us to come into a new month. So Psalms 81 and 3, this is the last verse.